I have a question for you. Have you ever had a desire to make somebody proud of you? Meaning, have you ever wanted your parents to be proud of you? Or maybe you wanted to make your kids proud of you, or your grandkids proud of you? How can you win the approval of those people closest to you? I'm gonna share that with you in today's success tip. By the way, my name is Jackie O'Quinn. I am a Destiny Global trainer here. We bring you a success tip just about every single week here on the Destiny Global Facebook page. This is totally free. You can come over here, you can get this success tip. The purpose in this success tip, or all the success tip, is to give you tangible, actionable training that you can start putting into practice right away. Now, typically, these are recorded for you live. They come up to you in the evening. However, my family and I, sorry, my phone's shaking there. My family and I are actually on vacation here in Florida, and I'm pre-recording this because we're on vacation. So you're gonna be watching this in the evening, but let me just go ahead and say this. If you saw the last success tip that I did, that success tip, we were talking about what holds people back. What is it that typically holds somebody back from having a success? That success tip was done on October 26th. You can go watch that video, or go watch that success tip here on the Destiny Global Facebook page. Just scroll back and go ahead and watch it. But today we're gonna build on part of that. And it's really, you know, a lot of times, well, let me just back up. Over the years, I've been studying people who want to have success. And many times when I've asked someone, why do you want to have success? And oftentimes they'll say, well, I want to live a better life, or I've got goals I want to accomplish. And if I keep saying, what else? What else? Typically, the second or third response, they want their parents to be proud of them if they're really young and they don't have kids, or if they have kids, sometimes they want their kids to be proud of them, or if they're older, they want their kids and or their grandkids to be proud of them. This is universal. So many people, no matter where they come from, no matter, you know, what generation they're in, they've got somebody close to them they want to be proud of. They want that person to be proud of them. They want their approval in some way. So today I'm going to talk to you, how do you get that approval from someone that is close to you? Now, in the last success tip, one of the things I mentioned, again, the one back on October 26th that I personally did, I mentioned in that video, I said that we'll never rise above the opinion that we have of ourselves. Think about that for a moment. You'll never rise above the opinion that you have of yourself. Now, one of the things that can help you learn to increase the opinion of yourself is when you start getting the approval of other people. When you hear someone encourage you, or you hear someone say they're proud of you, what that can do is it can almost in an instant start changing the belief that you have about yourself. Someone says, you know, wow, great job. Wow, you did awesome. I love how you did that. I'm so proud of you for doing X, Y, and Z. Mom, I'm so proud of you for this. Or Dad, I'm so proud that you did this. And something about getting the approval of someone who's close to you, it in an instant starts changing the opinion that you have of yourself. But there's a bit of a double-edged sword. How in the world do you get the opinion of other people? I'm gonna tell you that. First of all, I'm gonna go into more detail in my next success tip about what you can do with those people who tend to give you positive encouragement in your life. But let me just say this, positive encouragement is not natural for everyone. It's just not. Most people that you know are not naturally good encouragers. In fact, let me let you in on a little secret. A lot of times when someone says they're proud of you, it has a lot to do with how your success makes them feel about themselves. Meaning, imagine for a moment a parent has two kids. One's the black sheep of the family, right? They've always struggled in life. They've never quite figured things right. They've made one blunder after another. You know, they hung out with the wrong people. Maybe they got into petty crime. Maybe they were doing drugs. Maybe they had relationship problems. Maybe it was a combination of all those things. And even as an adult, getting into their, you know, 20s and even their 30s, they were just really struggling trying to get things figured out. And then you have another child. This is like the Harvard graduate, right? They're college graduate. They went to school. They got a great degree. They got a great career. Maybe they become a lawyer or something like that. Maybe they're a top supervisor or a top manager in a professional setting. And let me ask you, which one is the parent going to be most proud of most of the time? It's going to be the one that was successful, right? The one that went on and went to school, got a good education, a good profession, right? Why? Why is the parent most proud of that one? Because naturally, that child's positive career choices in life, positive life choices, reflects on that parent. Now, we're not going to get into a debate of whether it should reflect positively on the parent or not, because the truth is, as parents, we truly have no control with what our adult children and the decisions they make in their lives. You could be the best parent on the planet, right? And your kids could make horrible decisions. It's just, I mean, they're adults at that point, right? That's a whole other conversation for another time. But generally speaking, when a parent is proud of a child, an adult child who's doing well in life, oftentimes it's because they feel that that child is a positive reflection of them, right? And the child who's struggling, of course they love that child. They may love that child no less, but they're not gonna say, I'm proud of the poor decisions you're making, right? They're not gonna do that. They're not gonna say, what way to go, you screwed up again. They're not gonna say that if they're a good parent. So which one are they gonna focus more of their attention on naturally? Which one are they gonna talk about, brag about? Which one are they gonna say they're proud of, either directly to them or behind their back, the one who's doing well? So if you wanna win the approval of others, you need to move forward in a way that reflects positive on those people that are close to you. Now, you're sitting here thinking, but Jackie, I wanna do better, so I need people to believe in me. If I have more people believing in me, then I can succeed. How do I get more people believing in me? I know, it's an oxymoron. The way you get more people believing in you is you start creating a track record of success within yourself. But don't worry, that's not a success tip. I'm not stopping there. I'm not stopping just with that. You first have to start believing in yourself. Remember, you will only rise above the opinion that you have in yourself. So you first have to start changing the opinion that you have of yourself, because you will create an identity based on the opinion that you have of yourself. And it ends up being a constant feedback loop. If you believe poorly of yourself, if you believe I'm a procrastinator, I'm not smart enough to succeed. Listen, true story, we're down here in Florida on vacation. I have a gentleman with me, a friend of mine, and he says, hey, I can't quite figure out things that you know about finances or things that you know about business or investing. I'm not smart like that. And I told him, I said, stop saying that. Because the reality is most everything that I know, you just need an average intelligence to learn. I have average intelligence. I flunked out of a 2-year school. It took me 5 years to get a 2-year degree. Let me say it that way. It took me 5 years to get a 2-year degree. I was not a valedictorian. I was a borderline BC student in high school. I'm not crazy intelligent, but I can learn things. And I said, guess what? You can learn things, but you have to have the opinion that you can learn. It's also true. You have to have the opinion that you can succeed. I believe in my heart of hearts, with everything in me, that you're supposed to have success. Listen, you have a dream inside of you. You have something that you want to accomplish. That did not get there by accident. Not everybody has the same goals. Not everybody has the same dreams. Not everybody wants to be a doctor. Not everyone wants to be a lawyer. Not everyone wants to be an engineer. Not everyone wants to be a chef. Not everyone wants to be an entrepreneur. Not everyone wants to be a beautician, work in a salon, whatever you call that. Not everyone wants to be a massage therapist. But guess what? Each individual professions have people who dreamed of having that profession in their life. Like they dreamed of being that person. All of us have to have separate dreams in order for all of us to succeed as a society. Your dream was not accidentally planted inside of you. I believe that you have a purpose, and I believe your desire to accomplish something great, your desire to have success, or your desire to be successful so someone can be proud of you, whatever that desire that you have inside of you to accomplish something extraordinary, I believe 100% in my heart of hearts that you can do it, you're supposed to do it, and your desire and your goals are specific to you in this time and this place in your life. The only question is, how do you start accomplishing those goals? How do you stop self-sabotaging? How do you overcome those barriers? And you have to first start changing the opinion that you have of yourself, how you see yourself. So I'm gonna tell you right now that you have evidence of greatness all around you at this very moment, but you might not realize it because we tend to be our own worst critics. You know, maybe you had parents who condemned you or criticized you. Or maybe you were lucky enough that your parents were encouraging to you, but maybe you had coworkers or brothers or sisters or friends or, you know, grandparents or someone else who did criticize you when you made mistakes. And that stinks, that sucks. It never makes us feel good. But you know what? For most of us, We are our own worst critic. You don't need grandma or grandpa criticizing you. You can critique yourself well enough. You don't need your parents criticizing you. You can critique yourself well enough. God forbid, you don't need a spouse criticizing you. You criticize yourself more harshly than anyone else ever could. But I want you to understand that when you start criticizing yourself, when you start beating yourself up, like, oh, you're dumb, you're stupid, why did you make that mistake? You screwed up again. Why do you always have a habit of doing this? Why are you procrastinating? Whatever weakness you see in yourself, whenever you criticize yourself, the problem is you're overlooking the evidence of greatness that lies within you. And there's evidence all around you. Listen, you have to be a bit of a detective and you have to be intentional. I recently wrote an email and I said that the secret to success is intention. Most people think that success comes accidental or automatic. It's intentional. You have to be intentional about what you're thinking about. And you have to be intentional when you start looking for the evidence of the greatness that exists inside of you. Listen, if you have a goal and you're like, I want to start a business, and maybe you're thinking, I want to start a business and I want to, you know, do something, you know, start some sort of online business, or maybe you want to do some sort of local business. It doesn't matter. You want to start a business. Well, what are the steps it's going to take for you to start that business? Write them down. Go ahead and write them down. What are the steps it's going to take? And don't worry about if you don't know all the steps. Just think about what are the steps it's going to take with where you're at now to launching that business and, you know, having your first successful month. And we're just using a business as an example. It could be anything. Well, one step is, hey, I'm going to have to, you know, find out how to open this business. Where can I open this business? I've got to get the business opened. I've got to get supplies. I've got to find customers. Those are your steps. Great. Now you know what to work towards. You're going to work towards step number one. And step number one probably has a bunch of sub-steps. And we break this down in some of our business training. We talk about this at First Step Success sometimes. By the way, you've never been to First Step Success. Our very next First Steps to Success is going to be January 27th, 28th, and 29th in San Antonio, Texas. Go to the website, destinyglobal.com. Check the link, maybe a link in the comments. Check that link out. Get registered. That event tends to fill up quickly. If it's about learning how to start having success, breaking old belief patterns about yourself, like there's no better place to learn that than at First Steps to Success. Okay. So we're talking about becoming a bit of a detective and looking for evidence. If your goal is, I need to, you know, you're like, I need to find a building for my business, some sort of commercial space. Okay, then start looking for the commercial space. Now, here's what most people do. They go out, they start looking for their commercial building. They start, you know, and when they have an idea of where they might want that building, and they have an idea what that building might look like. And then all of a sudden they go out there, and they go, you know, they contact a real estate agent and they start looking at small commercial properties maybe, and they have this perfect spot they're looking at. Come to find out that building's entirely too expensive. It's outside of their budget. They're not gonna be able to open that space up or rent that space. And then they feel stupid because they had no idea that it was gonna be so expensive to get this commercial building because they've never owned a business before. And then they walk away from the meeting with a realtor. They feel self-defeated and they think about, God, I'm so dumb. Why did I think that was possible? You know, why did I ever think I could afford that? What was I thinking? How was I so silly to think that it was, you know, not gonna be that expensive? So they have all these self-defeating behaviors. What you have to do is start looking for the evidence that you're going to have success. The evidence was right in front of you the whole time. The evidence that you're going to have success is that you contacted a realtor, meaning you were moving towards the destination of opening a building, finding that location that you need, opening a building, opening a location. So the evidence is you contacted a realtor. The other evidence is you kept the appointment and went and met with a realtor. The other evidence is you learned what commercial pricing is on buildings like the one you want. You learned to prioritize pricing versus space. You probably learned where are other locations that you could potentially open. This entire appointment that you had in this case with a realtor looking at commercial property was not a failure. Quite the opposite. It was a tremendous success. But what are you focusing on? Are you focusing on the mistakes? Are you focusing on your successes? Listen, if you want people to be proud of you, then you've got to become the type of person that people want to be proud of. And you have to first be proud of yourself. So be proud. Be your own personal cheerleader. listen, other people's opinions can, you know, sway. Other people's opinions can easily be changed. Other people's opinions are just their opinions. But your opinion is the one that matters most. So start looking at the evidence that you are doing the right things and moving in a positive direction. All too often people say, I can't celebrate that because it's not a big enough, you know, it's not a big enough result. I didn't already find the building. I didn't already get it opened up. Yeah, I went and looked at 3 locations and none of them were gonna work. I'm such an idiot. I'm wasted time. No, you found 3 locations that didn't work. Keep going. You're gonna soon find the location that is gonna work. And by the way, I'm just using opening up a physical location, a physical business as an example. You may be trying to start another type of business. You may be doing something altogether different. You may be trying to create a website and start blogging, and all of a sudden you realize, hey, I want to put up a website. And then you realize there's a lot that goes into putting up a website, right? You need to learn how to write the messaging on the website. That should be done in a very specific way that gets results. You should learn design elements. You should learn what needs to go on the website. You should learn what sort of legal documents should be in your footer. And before long, you start to realize, this is a lot. I just want to get up a simple website. I thought I could just go hire someone to put up a website. All of a sudden, he's asking me for photos and wants to know what I want written on the website and how many tabs do I want on the website. And he's asking me about navigation and what sort of software should I use to, should the website be built on. And all of a sudden, I'm getting overwhelmed and this is too complicated. Listen, stop getting overwhelmed. Stop beating yourself up for what you don't know. Celebrate what you're learning. Here's one. You get a job, maybe you get a sales position, and all of a sudden, you know, you're like, I'm excited. There's a lot of opportunity here, a lot of, you know, chance for really good compensation. I got a lot of flexibility in my schedule. You go on your first sales appointment, whether it's in person or over the phone or in a webinar, you do that first presentation and it flops. You beat yourself up. You hear your you know, someone in your family says, oh, you know, sales is really hard. You shouldn't do it. And you're like, this is too hard and I don't feel good. I got rejected and I was a failure. Why did I think I could do this? And you can just really get wrapped up in this pity party. Stop. Just because you struggle, listen to me. I helped build a sales organization. We did over $100 million in sales commissions, paid out profits earned. It was an enormously successful international sales organization. Marketing strictly top-tier products. We're talking about anything from $1,300 all the way up to $11,000. We help all sorts of people succeed from, you know, 18 and 19 year olds. I think the oldest person who ever got started in the sales position was like 78 or 80. But I'm gonna tell you, so many people quit before they actually get started. But what's the evidence you're gonna be successful? The evidence is, in the sales position that we're talking about here, the evidence could be that you got the job. The evidence that you went and applied for the job. The evidence is you put your resume in order. The evidence is you went to the interview. The evidence is, after you got the job, you went on that first appointment. The evidence is that you actually prepared that presentation. Or here's one. Let's just say the sales is successful, but you didn't make as much money as you wanted. You know, you were trying to sell something that cost, you know, $5,000, $10,000, but they decided to buy something that was $500. So instead of making, you know, say $1,000 commission, you end up making like $50 or something. And it's like, oh, I'm never gonna make it. I'm gonna be broke. This is never gonna work. No, the evidence that you're gonna succeed is that on your very first appointment, you made a sale. That's evidence. The moment that you say, but the evidence isn't strong enough, the evidence isn't good enough, the moment that you say, I can't do it, or it should have been better, the moment that you do that, you're erasing all the progress that you've made. And listen, progress and recognizing progress is more important than the journey. Recognize your progress. As you start to succeed, as you start to win, your opinion about yourself starts to change. The person that you're becoming starts to change. And as you start to have success, you're gonna find that other people are attracted to your success. People who didn't believe in you will start to say, wow, I believe in you. I always knew you could do this. And I know that sounds crazy. I used to tell people when they get started in a sales position, I would say, go and practice your presentation on people that you know. And one of the reasons I would do it is because what would happen is sometimes they'd go practice on someone that would be like, well, you know, you did a good job, but you know, this is hard. I don't know if you're gonna be able to do this. And people would sometimes give them negative opinions. And that's good, because obviously if you're going to, you know, be in sales, you're going to hear negative opinions. You're going to get rejected. So it wasn't bad for them to be rejected. But I cannot tell you how many people would start to have success and they would say, oh yeah, you know, so-and-so who I practiced with early on said, you know, I couldn't do this. And now all of a sudden they're saying they're proud of me. They always believed in me. They forgot that at one point in time, they told me I couldn't do this. I'm going to give you a real life example. This is about me. So my first career, I was a nurse. Before I became an entrepreneur at 24, I was a nurse. I told you it took me 5 years to get a 2-year degree. That 2-year degree was my nursing degree. I flunked out of nursing school twice. I applied for a third time. And I shared part of this story in the video I did on October 26th, that success tip. Go back if you want the other part of the story, but I will tell you this. When I flunked out, one of the instructors told me, she pulled me to the side early on and she said, you should rethink being a nurse. She said, I don't think you're gonna be able to do this. I don't think you're gonna succeed with nursing school. Like, I just don't know if you're cut out for this. Now, mind you, this woman did not know me for Adam. And if I'm gonna be honest, I looked up to my nursing instructors. I was young, I was 19 years old. I felt fortunate to get into the nursing program. I wasn't supposed to get in. I was just applying to apply, and I just happened to get in. I was told I need to apply more than once, so I was trying to get that first time out of the way. I got in, and then right away, a month or so later, I've got one of the instructors in fundamentals of nursing. She tells me, I could tell you her name right now, but she says to me, you know, I just don't think you're cut out for this. Look, that crushed me at the time, but I pushed forward. And I will admit, the next second semester, I ended up flunking out, reapplied later, got all the way to my fourth semester, and flunked out. I think it was 5 semesters for the associate's degree. But my second to last semester, flunked out again. Reapplied at another school. Long story short, if you want to find out what happened in that school, go watch that other video on October 26th. But long story short, I graduated, did really well. Became a nurse. When I became a nurse, it just so happened my hospital was looking to promote non-traditional roles in nursing. Basically, it was an employment promotion. They wanted non-traditional ethnic and men, people of different ethnicities and men. They wanted basically anyone other than white women. They wanted to be able to promote them and put their pictures up all over town. So they did a photo shoot with me, and I was on this billboard in town. And I also had the local college that did a photo shoot with me, and they put me on their flyer. One of that same exact nursing instructor, at this point, I'm a nurse walking down the hallway. And at this point, my picture's been around town, is on a billboard and that sort of thing for a nurse for the local hospital that I'm working at. And this instructor, she sees me, she's an older woman, she come over, she said, Jackie, come here. Now mind you, about 3 years earlier, she's the one who told me I wasn't cut out for it, I can't do this. Jackie, come here. I walk over to her. She leans over to me. She's a short lady. She leans over she kind of put her hand on my shoulder and she said, I want you to know, I always believed in you and I was so proud of you. When I saw your picture up on that billboard, I knew you never graduated from our school, which was Wayne Community College. I knew you never graduated from our school, but I always knew you could do it. You never gave up. You're a great nurse. Great job. I'm so proud of you. And I said, thank you so much. And I walked off, and I didn't feel ill or anything else. I just thought, she doesn't even remember the conversation she had with me when she told me I wasn't cut out for it and I should find another career path. But here I am, in some way, reflecting positively on her, that she feels proud of who I am, and she felt a need to express that. And I took that as genuine encouragement. I knew she just forgot that she had discouraged me several years before. People's opinions of you can change, but your opinion of yourself has to first change. Start looking for the evidence in your own life of your impending success. And if you look for enough evidence, you'll start having the success you're looking for. Thank you so much for being here with us. Make certain that you get registered for January 27th, 28th, and 29th for the very next First Steps to Success. I look forward to seeing you there in person. We're going to dive really, really deep into this very topic. In fact, we have about 2 hours in total attributed to this topic right here over that 3-day event. You're not going to want to miss it. Look forward to seeing you there. Have a great evening. God bless.